chapter 17, verses 34 through 37. When we have it, say amen.
Amen.
But David said to Saul, "Your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. When a lion or a bear came and carried off a sheep from the flock, I went after it, struck it, and rescued the sheep from its mouth. When it turned on me, I seized it by its hair, struck it, and killed it. Your servant has killed both the lion and the bear. This uncircumcised Philistine will be like one of them, because he has defied the armies of the living God. The Lord who delivered me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear will deliver me from the hand of this Philistine."
Yes, sir.
And may this reading be a blessing to both the hearing and doing of God's holy word for the edification of our minds as well as our souls. You may be seated in the presence of our Lord.
This morning, the title of the sermon this morning is called, "I'm Different." I'm different. So many people could say, "I'm different." There's a popular rap song out now called, "I'm Different." He says, "The roof, I pull up and the roof is gone. And my finger up to the competition because I'm different." But I'm not different because the roof is gone, because actually it's just a convertible. It's not nothing special, you know. I'm not different because I'm different because there are times I sit in silence and just reflect on my life and the person that I am. I reflect on what I like. I like classical music. A lot of people don't like classical music, but I like classical music because it just relaxes my mind. I reflect on how I like tattoos. Some people think it's wrong, some people don't, but I like tattoos. I reflect on how I like rap music. Yes, I love Jesus, but I love rap as well. And I know some of y'all out there do too, because I've seen some of your Facebook posts and Instagram pictures and everything else. So it's okay, you're gonna say that. I'm different because I don't conform to what the crowd says is popular. The crowd believes that sometimes you have to have this status, or you have to have that status, or you have to have that amount of money, you have to drive that car, but I don't conform to the crowd because I'm different. The same doesn't satisfy me because I'm different. And just like me, I'm sure a few others here today are like David, because David was different. While others were running to battle, preparing the front line for defense for the war that was about to take place, David was tending to the sheep in the fields of his father's land, a far cry from being battle ready. So we think. In those first 36 verses, we see all the preparations being made on both sides of the battle line. But only one is bold enough to cross, or at least get close, and that's the Philistine Goliath. Goliath comes up and talks trash to the Israelites, saying day after day, daring them to make a move, placing bets on who was going to get what if either one was victorious, challenging their manhood. And I know there have been times in your life when people have challenged you in some kind of way. You know when people get on Facebook and mention you and mention your business, but if you don't tell your business, then they can't talk about you. You do realize that if you have 600 plus friends on Facebook, everybody ain't your friend. It's a lot of folks you can count, but you can't count on. You know, in that 600, there's some haters within that 600. People have stood in your personal space, running your mouth. Running their mouth. Like, you have to realize that, you know, I've known Jesus for a little while. A whole lot of folks have known Jesus for a little while, but there's a certain space out here. You know, give me 50 feet. Don't be just in my face talking. Don't be just in my face saying you're going to do this and you're going to do that, because there's a reality where if you don't, I'm going to have a Jesus, I'll be right back moment. You know what I'm saying? When people come up to you and be like, you know what, you ain't going to do this, you ain't going to do that, I'll be right back. those moments, they're going to make your priorities get out of order. Because if you take that, you have that Jesus, I'll be right back on me, and handle your business, there's a consequence usually after that. You know, usually you go to jail, or usually they're getting some kind of trouble. That's what I'm all for. That's fine. That's fine. What we must do as David did in verse 37, we must have faith as David demonstrated, proclaim that the same God who stood with me in the courtroom that said, not so, that gave you the job that said, and said that you were qualified even without the education, saw you with the gun in your hand and said, I still love you. Met you on a dope house with a pipe in one hand and the light in the other, said, you don't have to do that no more. Caught you on your way to the hotel with the car in the door and said, you better not. That's the same God. The same God that did all those things. The same God who delivered you then can help you now defeat this new Goliath. I dare you to tell the devil I'm different in 2013 because I'm keeping my priorities in order. Devil, you might try to look like a Goliath in my life, but I know that the same God who delivered me before is going to do it again. On a 2-for-1. He's going to do it on a 2-for-1. What's a 2-for-1? I'll tell you what's a 2-for-1. 2-for-1 is God will bless you with one hand and you'll bust the devil's with the other. You'll bust the devil's head with the other hand. I want a 2-for-1 here because I need that. You need that sometimes because you can't do it by yourself. But when God bless you with that 2-for-1, you'll be all right. He will bless you and bust the devil's head at the same time. It feels good to know that God has your back even in situations that may arise. But you know, everybody don't feel like that. Everybody don't feel like God has my back. Everyone doesn't feel like God loves me. But you may say, I can't handle this suddenly moment. You know those suddenly moments that he loved you for this long and then you tell him, I got a baby, and he's like, you know, those suddenly moments that when you said good morning that morning and then the next morning they're gone. Those suddenly moments when you know you've been doing everything you could to stay right on the job, but they tell you that we don't need you no more. Those suddenly moments. God, where are you at in those suddenly moments? Yes, God, you delivered me once, but this time is different. It's too big for you, God. You can't deal with what's going on with me right now. This is more stressful than before. There's a greater heartache at this time. I just can't believe this is happening to me. God, you wouldn't understand this issue. I know you understand each and every other issue I've told you about, but you ain't gonna understand this issue right here. Lord, how can I keep my priority in order in 2013 when all hell is breaking loose all around? Come on. It's in my life. Every time I turn around, there's hell on this side. And there's hell on this side. I back up, and I'm burning back there. And I'm stepping forward, and I'm burning right there. But how can I keep my priorities in order in 2013 when all hell is breaking loose? Come on. Well, the first thing you got to do is realize that talk is cheap. Realize talk is cheap and doesn't deserve any reaction. Look at verses 28 through 30. David's brother comes running his mouth, trying to tell David all about himself and who he was. You know how people try to tell you, you can't do this, you can't do that, you ain't really supposed to be doing that. Right. And why he can't go to battle with Goliath. But David does something in verses 29 and 30 that we should all do. Don't acknowledge cheap talk. People start talking cheap, start talking mess to you, like, you been gone with that. I ain't dealing with that right now. Don't acknowledge cheap talk and just walk away. There's no need to waste time on foolish chatter and unwanted conversation. Because the reality of it is there's more, if David's brother was more than just a mouth, he would have been able to beat Goliath already. He wouldn't have worried about telling David you can't do this because it had already been over. Some people always have something to say, blah, blah, blah. Sometimes you just want to say, shut up, please.
Yeah.
With your Jesus mind. With your Jesus mind. Because there's sometimes you don't want to say, shut up, please. You want to, you know.
Yeah, right.
You know, some people still struggle. I still struggle sometimes. You know, it's okay if you don't want to admit it. If you don't want to, that's fine. I know the truth. You're making my head hurt with all this cheap talk. I don't have enough hair for all this mess. You keep it up, okay? I ain't got time for all this. Cheap talk. Don't acknowledge cheap talk.
Come on.
The second thing you have to do is understand that in battle, your friend's armor will not fit you.
So what God does, he gives you a tailor.
Wait, hold on, not yet. I don't need that jacket yet.
Hold on. So what God does is, well, let's say you have a tailor. And your tailor puts this jacket on, right? He tries to get you ready, get you together because you got things to do, but that jacket doesn't fit you, does it? Let's see, let's check it out. Let's pull it there. Let's check that. That doesn't
work for you, sir. You look like you're being swallowed up. It doesn't work. No? Let's try that one. I think that one really looks better for you, okay?
Okay. So you have a jacket that you tried on but it doesn't fit. But God creates an armor that's custom fit to you. He creates an armor that's custom fit to you. Exactly your size, exactly your style.
So then after your tailor leaves, God sends you an image consultant. What's an image consultant turn from? What's an image consultant? An image consultant is someone that comes to you and tells you exactly what you need, how you need them, and what you should do. Gets you ready for your future, not your past. Right? So God sends you an image consultant and what we call the Holy Ghost. So when he sends you your image consultant, your image consultant looks at you, examines you, and says, yes, that works. That armor fits well, but you're missing something. Oh, you're missing this because it has all your contracts through 2020 signed and ready to go. All your contracts, including the one for the hotel, the Virgin Hotel they built in 2017 downtown. He has you signed and ready, but you're still missing something. What are you missing? The Holy Ghost is just looking at you and trying to figure out what you're missing because he knows you. He knows what you need. He knows what you seek and what you desire, but he's trying to figure out what else do you need? And he gives you your word. He gives you your word because he knows you need in order for you to go through 2020 with those contracts. You gotta have your word with you because there's gonna be some times that people come up against you because they think you're not qualified. They look at you like you because you're this, because you're that. You don't have what you need, but the Holy Ghost gives you what you need with your word.
So now you're fully suited in your armor. He has you ready to go. Are you ready to go? Are you ready to do this? You won't even have to answer because the Holy Ghost already told you. You got it. All you got to do is walk in it. Right?
Verse 38, Saul wants to fit David with his armor, but because David is different, it wasn't comfortable that did not fit him. Our armor is custom made for us like a custom suit. The jacket is measured for your body. It has the right length. Your suit, your pants fit in a certain way with your waist, because a lot of people sometimes are in between. Like for me, I'm at like a 41. And when you go to the store, you can't just go 41. You gotta either go 40 or 42. So because he sends you a custom-made armor, a custom-made suit, because he wants it to fit you, because when you're in battle, you don't want nothing just snugging, holding you back or holding you down because it's too big or it's too small. God knows our measurements from our head to our feet to ensure a proper fit. Don't try to wear your friend's armor when you have your own. Point number 3 is, realize the bigger they are, the harder they fall. From verses 41 through 45, Goliath exchanged words with David, you know, telling him what he was going to do, and David was telling him what he was going to do. But the reality of it is, Goliath just didn't know what was about to happen. So if you look at verses 46 through 47, verses 46 through 47 says, this day the Lord will hand you over to me, and I will strike you down and cut off your head. Today I will give the carcasses of the Philistines' army to the birds of the air and the beasts of the earth, and the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. All those gathered here all know that it is not by sword or by spear that the Lord saves, for the battle is the Lord's, and He will give all of you into our hands, meaning the Philistines. Today. From verses 41 through 45, David and Goliath exchange words with each other. But from 46 to 49, David gives Goliath a personal benediction and took the giant down with one swing. So today you need to tell the devil today that it's time for you to go. It's time for you to go, devil. You won't have no sex over here no more. You won't have no play here no more. You can use what Erykah Badu said. You can call Tyrone. I don't really care what you do, but you gotta go. Your time is up. You've wasted too much of my time. I'm keeping my priorities in order in 2013. In this life's battles in the trenches, it can be giant to us. Nipsco Beatles, giant. Fluctuating gas prices, a giant. Grocery shop. Have y'all been to the grocery store lately?
Yeah.
Grocery shop, a giant. These giants can be scary and at times unpredictable. But God has chosen us to be different with custom battle armor and the faith that in spite of it all, I can keep my priority in order because it's not over until God says it's over. Amen.
To declare to you, my past is over in you. Things are made new. Surrendered my life to Christ. I'm